How y'all doing out there? This is Black Enterprise, the home of the Black Effect. And I want to go ahead and get into this topic quickly. Recently, I saw the interview done with Majesty. And this is Big Stretch's brother. If you don't know who Big Stretch is, Big Stretch used to run with the Live Squad. And he's mostly known for running the big tall guy, running with Tupac. He's mostly known for the guy that you see in the movies, the tall guy that you see in the Tupac documentaries or films, where when he gets robbed and when Tupac get robbed in Quad Studios, that was supposed to be his, that was the guy, that the tallest guy who Tupac felt should have did more for him when he was getting robbed. Now, I want to get into this, and I don't, you know, this isn't any disrespect to the dead, you know. We all know that they on their other, they have a bigger journey. You know, they ain't worried about nothing else that's going on here. But I don't want to allow to go on is these false narratives though. And I hate what really kills me, you know, is I got love for, you know, the homie Pac, man. You know what I'm saying? That was my brother. Definitely a modern day prophet out here, you know, and we all have love for Pac, but and Big, and you know, but we want to have the truth get out there. Only thing that's left is the truth. And when people are dead, the only thing we have is the truth. And what I want to say for the dude Majesty, those interviews, is I get that that's your brother, fam, but quit trying to paint him as a saint, bro. Quit trying to paint him like he didn't, you know, like Pac wasn't mad at him and didn't think that he was phony, you know. Those songs that Pac made were about Big Stretch. We already know that. The first verse in Holla At Me, you know, pretty much basically just glass Big Stretch. I mean, those lyrics were heartfelt. Like, that's how, like, we knew this back in the day. Like, we knew this at the time that he was talking about Big Stretch. We didn't have to wait till now and see a bunch of YouTube videos. The interviews Pac told you, you know what I'm saying, how he felt about what Big Stretch did. Tupac said that out of his own mouth. So when, for what Majesty is talking about, bro, like, I understand how you would like to, and it seemed like how you would like to paint your brother as that, is this hero figure and things like that. And maybe to you, he was, you know, but you got to understand, bro, like, that may not have been his character to the world or to his friends. Now, the lyrics, man, Pac say, are you confused? You wonder how it feel to walk a mile inside the shoes of a nigga who ain't have a thing to lose. Me and you was homies. No one before me. It was all a scheme. You infiltrated my team and sold the nigga dreams. That nigga said, like, him and Pac, Big Stretch and Pac was supposed to be like how Suge and Pac was. If you see, Pac was always, you know what I'm saying, looking for those type of figures. Like, you know, that and looking for that camaraderie, you know what I mean? Like, his, like, that's how brothers are, you know, looking for that brother, like that brotherly love. That's what people look for in gangs. That's why little niggas get out the, don't have no fathers, nobody, no male figures to care about them, and they join gangs. But see, these gangs don't really care about them. They don't have their best interests at heart. They use them. You know, now, Tupac and Stretch was cool. They wasn't in, like, these were brothers. Like, this is why it's so bad. This is like, you know, you have a brother. Like, think about somebody like Stringer Bell and Avon or something like that. You go through everything. Or think about your own sister. If you're a woman, think about your own sister. Think about, you know, your own brother. If you go through everything with this person, struggle, from the struggle to the ground up. And then you have, you know, and then some, y'all talk about everything. Y'all talk about what you're gonna do if somebody do this. You talk, that's how niggas is. I know that. I know that from coming from the environment in the hood. You talk about amongst your people, like, what you gonna do if something happened. That's like y'all planning. Cause you know it could happen. So we be like, man, if a dude run up on you, bro, like, you know, I'm gonna come around that way. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna do this. You know what I'm saying? But ain't no nigga, I ain't going for nothing. Ain't no nigga taking me. So that's what Pac was disappointed in Big Stretch in. That when it was really, you say you're part of the Live Squad, you say you get live, but when it's lit and it's live, you don't do nothing. Pac said, man, I got two double Glocks, nigga. I got the Glocks on me. If you had subdued those guys instead of just sitting around hitting the deck, I could have busted at him. But this is what Pac said. He said, me and you was homies. No one before me. It was all a dream. Infiltrated my team and sold the nigga dreams. How could you do me like that? I took your family in. I put some cash in your pocket. Made you a man again. And now you let the fear put your ass in a place complicated to escape. That's a fool's fate. I let the world know, nigga. You a shell of a man. I lost respect for you, nigga. We can never be friends. I know I'm running through your head now. What could you do? If it was up to you, I'd be dead now. What Pac meant by that, like, is you heard that in an interview where Big Stretch, and Big Stretch said a lot of, when you just let people talk, they say the truth and incriminate themselves and say things out their mouth. But if you would pay attention, there was a recent interview where you found out that Big Stretch was having communications with Jimmy Henchman. You know what I'm saying? While Pac was beefing with him, Stretch was having a liaison conversations with him, going back and telling Tupac what Jimmy Henchman said. This, what kind of like friend is that, man? You know, like that's eerie. It's like, bro, you need to be like, man, nigga, why you calling us, man? Why you calling me? It's lit. It's up. You know what I'm saying? That's my brother. Well, I don't know why you got no problem with my brother, but you know, it's lit. It's up. You know, and that's what I get from the dude, Majesty. Every time you hear him talking about mentioning Tupac, he always trying to discredit him in some way. Oh, man, he wasn't perfect, man. You know, he was a man. So was your brother, bro. Your brother wasn't perfect, and your brother was a grimy dude. Like, we know that. Grimy, we know what the word mean. Y'all know what that mean in New York. Grimy meaning that he'll set up, damn near set up his own brother. You know what I'm saying? That's what that mean. Now, look, I know, again, bro, it's all due respect, but we going to keep it 100 and we going to tell the truth. Your brother is gone. So, you know, the people still here on the young youth, we not finna feed them a bunch of lies and a bunch of BS. The story, the Judases and all that, we going to point them out. I'm not, you know, now, again, this is what Pac felt. He was there. You know, Big Stretch was there. So, no, regardless of whatever niggas who were nerd feel, you know what I'm saying? You could feel that way. But, no, that's not what happened. Like, you know, and how it went down was a horrible situation, man, where someone could have got killed. Pac said, man, you know I'm running through your head. After the Quad Studio shooting and Pac did those interviews saying what how he felt about Big Stretch, how he felt betrayed, man. He said he felt betrayed by him. Like, that you just hit the deck. You know I got the two double Glocks. You saying that if we get in some beef or something, like, nigga, run up. You ain't going like that. You saying that you gonna take care of business. But you didn't do that. You hit the deck. You know, and you let them niggas grab me up. And I'm pretty sure Pac seen everything. Like, you know, things move in slow motion. When adrenaline is rushing and action is going on. If you a person like Pac and you know you've been in things before, stuff starts to go into slow motion when it's active like that. I'm pretty sure he saw the looks on everybody's face and it lasted for a long time to him. Like, he could replay it in his mind to see the look on nigga faces, like looking on nigga faces, like how they be looking, you know, looking goofy and shit, you know, looking like they know what's going on and look, just looking goofy, you know, and that disgusted Pac. If you look at the, you know, the dude Majesty interviews, like, bro, it's like, you know, it's like, man, it's something off there. It's like, bro, you know, he keep looking down. You know, come on, man. You know, tell the truth, shame the devil, bro. You know, and for the dude, I know the dude Art just doing his, you know, he doing his thing. Shout salute to him, man. He do great interviews. But, bro, I know it's got to be hard for you just to sit through that stuff knowing what you know. You know what I'm saying? I know you want to put the full court grills on, dude. And it's like, bro, like, look, you know, again, it was a lot of shady. Your brother was doing a lot of shady stuff in that situation. Pac say, like, you said that he didn't know that he was beefing with Big. Like, come on, man. You tell him, come on, man. You know Pac, like, y'all. But the thing is y'all didn't go up there to visit him. You didn't talk to him. So you didn't. So the dude gets shot. He gets shot up. And then y'all making some excuse, talking about some IDs and talking about all this stuff, man. That's that excuses. I would have left y'all niggas too. If it were me and I were Pac, man, I would have, bro, both of y'all niggas would have been ostracized. You know what I'm saying? Wouldn't have been able to get no more money with us. And that's what Pac did. Pac left Stretch Ass in New York, you know what I'm saying? And all them Live Squad and just bounced, bro. Like, man, I can't deal with them. And when they fuck with Big Syke and when it messed with Big Shug, he was like, I got to get with some real cats, man, because my life is real. Niggas, like, you know, what you expect? Like, and I say this for Majesty, bro. Like, if this was you and your brother, you know what I'm saying, your brother was still alive. And he did that to you. Like, you know, y'all talking or something, and then some dude run up on you with a gun, and you just see him just turn his back or just bag up. And, you know, instead, when he could grab, put himself in harm's way a little bit, grab the dude while he, you know what I'm saying, while he grabbing the gun, you could bust at the nigga and bust his head. You could just basically put the gun to the dude's head while the nigga Stretch is manhandling the dude. You could just go up to the dude and just work him some. Bomb, bomb, bomb. Shoot him a couple of times. Like, come on, man. I don't want to hear all that hindsight. And just because you cool with the Outlaws don't mean nothing. Them niggas phony too. Like, half the Outlaws is phony. The only nigga I rock with out of them is the dude who is a Muslim over there. He, you know, over there in the block. The Mutai, that's the realest one. Like, the, you know, he real, I get it to him. Like, you could, he tells the truth, you know, he gave his life to the Lord. He don't have no reason to lie. You know what I'm saying? But the rest of them dudes, man, after Edie, I mean, bro, come on, bro. You never was on it, bro. Like, you, I don't believe you would have did nothing when the beef was on, like, back in the day. I'm not trying, no disrespect. I'm just telling you, maybe you can correct me, you know what I'm saying? Maybe, but I don't see you as doing nothing, bro. You know what I mean? Like, Pac, yeah, I was just little niggas around Pac, man. Pac really just was a kind soul, and when it got his family. That's the problem, and you know, but the real soldiers, you know, and the Outlaws, they dead. They died with Pac. That's how they were supposed to, you know, that's what was supposed to happen. That's why, you know, again, you can't retcon and try to make it seem like, you know, Big Stretch, you know, you can't try to reconcile his character, you know, or anything like that, bro. You know, now that's your brother. You can love him. How, you know, no one saying anything about that. But don't try to make it sell us a dream, sell us a different character than what we got. Okay? Because like I say, man, listen, man, Pac was deep with the lyrics. That man said, how could you do me like that? I took your family in. I put some cash in your pocket, made you a man again. And now you let the fear put your ass in a place complicated to escape. And, you know, like, so because when Pac left them and was like, man, look, that nigga said, I let the world know, nigga, you could never be live until you die. I see a bitch in your eyes. And I said what I say. When Pac was, when he was dropping to the ground and all that was going on, he saw that stuff in slow motion. He saw the robber face. He saw his nigga. He saw Littles. He saw Nichols or whatever. He saw Big Stretch, big ass. He saw him, the look on his face as he was getting down. Like, Pac, like, man, I got these two double Glocks. We was just talking about if niggas run up, bro. You know what I'm saying? You will be the nigga. And ain't nobody saying you got to jump in front of the bullets and all that. But who give a damn? Like, you know, ain't that your man? Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't try to, hold on, that's how we get down. You know what I'm saying? Like, if that's your man's, bro, and you say, you know, and niggas is coming for him, like, you shouldn't, you, what's the problem with laying down your life for your man? Some, oh, well, we Secret Service now? Man, if you not gonna get busy when it's funky, why the hell you even around? Point blank, period, man. You know, now Pac say, without your word, you a shell of a man. I lost respect for you, nigga. We can never be friends. Who he lose respect for, Majesty, if he wasn't talking about your brother? Who? You thought he was talking about Biggie? Nah. That's the situations and scenarios don't equate. Biggie got bigger, you know what I'm saying, once he left and got from Pac. He took Pac's style and left. But Pac helped Big Stretch. Took him from, you know, poverty. Put him, you know, made him a man in front of his family. And when he left, Big Stretch went into obscurity and could never get his career off. But you see how Pac, when you see how mad he was with him? That nigga Pac said, how could you do me like that, man? Come on. But I want y'all to listen to the greatest rapper who ever lived tell you from his own mouth.
Hello.
And sadly, we know that Big Stretch passed. He was killed on the exact date, the anniversary of Pac being shot at Tupac Quad Studios. Now, you can be a believer in coincidences and things of that nature, but you also can be a gullible douchebag too. So you do whatever you want with the information that you presented, but I tend to want to use it, you know, properly and intelligently. So with that being said, it's your man, Nico B. Again, God rest the dead. This ain't no beef, ain't nothing. It's number love, but we want the truth, man. We don't want all. I hate the niggas who be goofy dancing around everything, trying to act like, oh, I can't talk about, man. Nigga, talking about you can't talk about it, man. This case still open. Who give a damn? Case been open, gonna be open, and it's until people talk. That's the reason why it's been open, because y'all niggas ain't did nothing. Y'all have been the cowards, ain't been telling on. Y'all haven't been saying nothing. Y'all ain't been getting justice for y'all people. So at the end of the day, man, what the hell you talking about? You know what I mean? But again, we just want the truth, man. You know, tell the truth, shame the devil. It's your man, Nico B. I'm Gizon.
With them too. Yeah, Stretch had the whole shit up. He was in cahoots. He was giving us play-by-play where they was at. The whole, on their way there, he was in communication with Jimmy and shit. You know, Jimmy promised them two big eights and shit.
Wow. So he sold Pac out for a quarter brick, basically.
Basically.